to the Rhode Show kitchen we go this morning, where our friends at Discover Newport have been kind enough to bring us this man. To my left, it's Chef Richard Allaire. Good morning, sir.
Hello there. How are you doing?
I'm great. Thank you so much for joining us. You are from the Metacom kitchen in Warren.
Right.
Tremendous new spot for people unfamiliar. Where are you located?
We're located at 322 Metacom Ave, right at the end in Warren.
Outstanding. Well, I am a Warren native, so I'm very proud to have you here today. And today we're making the warm vegan fall vegetable salad. Take us through some of the ingredients.
Well, the vegetables this time of year are really beautiful, and so we're taking advantage of that. So we're going to use butternut squash, some mushrooms, some spring onions, cauliflower, endive, kale, and an ingredient that I really associate with the fall, which is pomegranate.
Fantastic. Yeah, that is, I must say, that is a good-looking squash right there.
Yeah.
And a good-looking hand, too. Yeah. Well, this is not something that people should be intimidated to tackle if they want to make it at home, is it?
Definitely not. No, it's very simple. It's cut vegetables that are roasted and then mixed with kale at the end.
Sure, and is this something that you really enjoy preparing, especially this time of year, I would imagine, but I assume it's on the menu?
It's not on the menu.
Not on the menu.
It's not on the menu.
Glad
but,
I asked.
But it could be.
All right.
But, you know, everyone has their own idea what fall flavors are. Mm-hmm. And for me, when I think of fall flavors, I think of pomegranate, I think of mushrooms, I think of bitter lettuces. So this is just kind of my idea of what fall should taste like.
Yeah, well, is that one of your challenges as a chef, as someone who's a culinary master? You know, you're always trying to come up with a new thing that might eventually find its way into the restaurant.
Well, you come up with new things, but you also rely on the old things.
The old standbys.
Like things that the first time I saw some of these ingredients paired together was 12 years ago.
Nice.
So it's in a different form, but it's the same profiles that I really like.
Tremendous. Well, we will follow your lead here this morning. This is Chef Richard. He is from Metacom Kitchen in Warren. You don't want to miss the preparation of the warm vegan fall vegetable salad right here on the Rhode Show. For now, back over to you.
Thanks so much. Discover Newport has brought us Chef Richard. He is from Metacom Kitchen, and we have got a nice, interesting take on a salad today. It's actually a warm salad incorporating some nice fall flavors.
Yes. So it's first time I saw a hot salad was when I was in France.
Okay.
And it was a big salad bar, and you make all your salad, then you give it to a cook at the end, and he cooked it, and it was an incredible experience.
Huh.
So this is sort of a version of that, something I saw a long time ago. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut vegetables very thin.
Okay.
We're going to roast them. And after they're roasted, we're going to mix it with kale and dress it with some extra other things.
Kale, we've been hearing a lot about over the years.
Yeah,
one of those superfoods,
right.
Very nutritious. Right. Now, how are we slicing the vegetables?
So here's
today?
What I do. This is a Japanese mandolin. And what I did was I took the top of a butternut squash,
mm-hmm.
and I made planks. And then we're going to take the plank, and we're just going to take it, and we're going to simply shave it very, very thin.
Now, this is something, if you have one of these at home, probably not something that you want the kids to help out with, because it is a very sharp blade.
It's very sharp. It's like using a razor blade, but it's very effective, and you can see.
Makes for quick work.
You can see how very thin.
Wow.
And those are.
I can see through that.
We're going to do that with butternut squash, and we're also going to do it with kale, a cauliflower.
I never think to slice.
Yep.
Cauliflower is so thin. I feel like cauliflower
is one
keep
of those
it in florets, like
yep.
the broccoli.
It makes it much more tender, much more delicate.
Huh.
So
they are very delicate slices. That's
so now
for
we
sure.
have that.
Could you eat these raw?
You could.
Like once you slice them,
could
you then?
Yep. There's
okay.
the cauliflower. It's almost
wow.
almost transparent. So what we do from here
nice.
Is we'll take this. We'll take all these vegetables that we shaved. And we're going to mix it with some onions, olive oil,
great.
And pomegranate molasses.
And then are those getting roasted in the oven?
And then we're going to put them in the oven.
Beautiful. All right, we are well on our way. We'll give those a toss. We'll get them in the oven, and then we will finish the salad a little later on.
Thanks so much to Discover Newport for bringing this Chef Richard Allaire. Metacom Kitchen's a place we've got warm vegan fall vegetable salad on the menu, and it smells really, really good. We were saying, I'm not sure if it's the pomegranate oil or if it's the champagne vinegar that you have here. But you can
everything.
Really smell it.
It's the mushrooms, it's the pomegranate.
A little bit of everything.
It's all those fall flavors.
It's
that
got
we
those
like,
fall
right?
flavors. All right, so what do we need to do right now?
So what we're going
to
do now is we have the vegetables roasted.
Okay.
So we're going to finish the salad in the pan.
And what kind of mushrooms are those again?
These are called maitake and brown beach mushrooms, a type of cultivated Japanese mushroom.
In the grocery store, though?
The maitakes, yeah. Actually, at this time of the year, they grow wild. They're called hen of the woods, and they grow at the base of oak trees.
Oh, all right.
But these are a cultivated version of the hen of the woods mushrooms.
Okay.
Who knew?
Actually, you know what? Now that you say that, I'm looking at these, and I think, nope, I have these at home.
Right? Oh, really?
Underneath the oak trees.
There it is.
Yeah.
So
really nice.
So what we're going to do is we're going to add our roasted squash, endive, and onions to the pan.
You had that in the oven just for a little bit.
Yep. Those only roasted for about 10 minutes.
Okay.
So from here, we're going to finish making the salad now. So we'll take it out of the pan into a bowl.
So they really just need to be warmed up just for just for a minute. And this is something, too, I know we mentioned that this is a vegan salad, and a lot of times I think if you're not vegan, you hear that term, and sometimes you stray away from it because you think, this isn't hearty, this isn't going to fill me up.
Or the flavor isn't going to be there either, yeah.
Well, you know, I didn't really think about it until the restaurant was just opened a year ago yesterday. And
congratulations.
Happy anniversary. Thank you. And so what happened was we had people coming in, and they were vegans, and they said, can you do something for us? So we would do it. But we would try to do it at a high level, at the same level that we do all the other food.
Sure.
And more vegans are coming in. So we certainly welcome it, and we welcome them and the challenge of, you know, making them as satisfied as everybody else without any kind of animal products whatsoever.
Right.
So that's what this is. So this is the salad.
Too.
So what we're going to do here, and if you're not vegan, what I would do is take some blue cheese, Roquefort or something, freeze it, and shave it over the top.
Nice.
It'll be really nice with the pomegranate and all the other flavors that are going on. So what we're going to do here, plate it. And then I have a couple of little garnishes that we're going to add on. We're going to add quinoa that we overcooked, dried, and then fried.
Okay.
So it's very crunchy.
Mm-hmm.
And then
I've
we also have
fried quinoa.
And then we also have candied pine nuts.
I love the pine nuts too.
Now, how did you candy them? Because they look almost red in color.
Yep. Well, we did it. We made a simple syrup with sugar and water. Added smoked paprika. Cooked them in that, and then put them in the oven.
Okay.
So we have a few different things going.
And that's this right here, right? So this is the quinoa.
Yep, that's the quinoa.
Okay.
So we're gonna add that over the top.
I can hear that even crunching in your fingers when you're picking it up.
And then
some of the pine nuts.
And we have pine nuts.
And this is great for texture, like you said, because with all those vegetables roasted and they've all kind of softened up and feel the same.
And then, so we have the cauliflower, the mushrooms, the squash, the kale, and that's it. And all we're going to do is there's a little bit of garlic oil that we made at the restaurant. We're just going to finish it with that. And you can add some more pomegranate molasses to it if you want.
That looks so good.
You could add pomegranate seeds to it if you want.
Right.
There's a lot of different directions that you can take this.
Okay, really, so what about the restaurant? Out. Because you said fall is your favorite time of year, actually, to be cooking.
It is great.
To be creating different things. So this is it. We're here. What are you guys doing?
Well, right now, this is something that we play around with. Right, you know, the squashes are coming in, so we're doing different types of soups, different types of salads with it as well. There are certain flavors that I associate with fall, and that's with, like, bitter lettuces, like endive and escarole and things like pomegranate, and just maybe a little bit different from the typical, like, cinnamon. And we don't even use cinnamon that much because we kind of use other kinds of things with it.
Right.
With those.
Well, this looks great. Let's,
here you go. I got you. You're looking for a fork.
I am. I'm going to look for a fork because, man, it really does. It just looks so great. I mean, with all of these different flavors in here, and I love.
And you're right. A lot of different scents coming through.
The pine nuts that are in here.
You're going to get a nice crunch.
And the warmness of it is just—it's just nice in the fall.
Mm-hmm.
Oh man,
yeah, you're right.
Salads aren't one of those things that you typically associate with
that
serving.
That is so good.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, you want it
so
to be
good.
You want it to be very sort of rich but clean at the same time, and that's what we're trying to do here.
And I can see
it has a lot of texture.
It has a lot of texture. Whatever the salt that's put on top tastes great, and even those mushrooms would really be a hearty something very filling.
Right.
Because you see a salad and you think, all right, it's maybe not going to fill
It could also be a side dish on its own, too.
Right.
It could be an accompaniment to it.
No, that really is. That has such a great taste. Fish. Really, really good.
All right. Well, you're going to have to give this one a try for yourself. Don't forget, you can find the recipe over at roadshow.com.